Okay, hi guys. Well, hey, it's Jazz. We're back with another video. I guess we're just gonna jump back into it. I'm with my sister. Say hi.
Hi.
So today's video is about girls talk, obviously, as you saw by the title. So I'm just gonna talk about I'm gonna talk about some topics with you guys for my girls. Just in, like, if you have not very helpful peers, family, friends, all of that. So the first topic is our hygiene. So basically the few, I guess, basic steps that you want to do with your hygiene. Always wear deodorant. Spray deodorant is better because the stick deodorant will get on your clothes and it will leave a white rash on it. On your clothes, where the armpit area is, so spray deodorant is best. It lasts longer. It's colder, but it is better. Shaving. You don't have to shave, but if you don't want to shave, at least, you know, trim it down because body hair does contain body odor. And you just don't want that type of body odor. But if you're old enough and allowed, or you have a job, get waxes because shaving ingrown hairs. Leaves ingrown hairs. Those are BITCH trying to get those out. So I just wax or trim, shave if you want to be bare but can't wax. For bathing, I'm not gonna judge you based on your bathing situation. Just at least make sure you smell good. But as a girl, you have a odor very easily because of all your intimate body parts. So for your private part, use unscented soap or warm water. Don't use scented soap, like the soap that smells good and that stuff, because it's not good for you. I know everybody thinks, I thought this at one point, because it makes you smell good. No, baby, you're gonna get an infection and other things like that. So yes, just make sure you bathe at least 4 times a week. And exfoliate too, if you want to. You don't have to, but exfoliate as well. How to get over your ex. So, Alana, you can put in words if you need to. But how to get over your ex, or just a person in general. That's with boys and girls.
The other ones, like the other topics.
This could be for boys and girls. But basically, you just have to make your, if it was a bad relationship, I'm gonna start out with that. You just have to make yourself realize that that was not the person for you, and that's okay. Like, not everybody will be for you, not everybody is for you, not everybody's meant to stay. You just have to get that mindset in and you will be okay. And if it was a good relationship ending, or like it ended on good terms, you know, the same thing. It's the same thing, but you could be friends with them, you could not be. Sometimes it doesn't help.
I like to add in, like, if you're trying to get over ex, you just gotta have that mindset that it was probably just right person, wrong time, because I do believe in that. Or don't look like that, or like just like realize that they were not worth it and you're worth it, and you don't need no man, no girl for yourself. Hey, and be alone.
You're not even alone. Sorry. Anyway. Okay. Basically, just keep that mindset that not everybody's, it's a puzzle piece. Not everybody fits like 2 puzzle pieces. how to be confident. So as a girl in society nowadays, actually in all days, having confidence can come off as a lot of things, but I'm just telling you this, ignore it. You're not stubby or self-absorbed. If you are, go for it. I support all of that, but basically it's confidence. Having confidence is a mindset, and that's like kind of obvious, but it's literally just a mindset. Like, you don't have to dress a certain way or look a certain way or talk a certain way. It's just a mindset. If you're confident, you're automatically attractive, but people automatically want to be around you because you're confident, because you give out that type of energy. So I would just, if you struggle with that, just affirmations. It's going to be hard, like, for the first couple months, couple weeks, because it's just like, I'm just talking to myself. No, you're, like, speaking it into the universe. If you don't believe that, then you're believing that, then you're speaking it into whatever religion you believe in or whatever you believe in. Like, you're just saying it out loud to make it come true. It's just the mindset. You just gotta tell yourself, I'm beautiful, I'm handsome, this and that. Like, everybody wants me. Just stuff like that.
It was long distance.
Not doing that. Okay, I have a few more. But, okay. I'm just gonna give you guys some advice, too. One, don't send nudes. Like, I know.
Because they can get leaked as much as that person asks you. Manipulate, gaslight you, be like,
oh, can you not interrupt
me? You don't love me?
Can you not interrupt me?
I'm just saying.
Another tip, don't interrupt me,
girl.
Or any other girl. That is so rude for no reason. She could have just said, excuse me. No, now you don't get excused. As I was saying, don't send nudes. I know it's like, okay, I trust this person. If you're going to send nudes, honestly, I will wait till you're, like, grown. I will wait till you're grown to send nudes, because it's like, you're in high school or middle school, even elementary school, like, that stuff will get around. I hope it does not get around for either one of you, or even if my sisters were in that situation, or my brothers, like, I hope that would never happen, because I know that's very embarrassing and just traumatic, but I just don't do it. I know a lot of people be like, don't do it, because it's like child pornography. I'm just telling you, because it will ruin your whole mindset of everything.
In life.
It wouldn't ruin your life, for real. I mean, but then there's
what reputation?
There's digital.
Okay.
Alright, you know what? This is why I brought my other light, because that right there was straight disrespectful.
Oh, that's bright.
Oh! Wow. Oh, wait, it's fine right there. Yeah, just, y'all, I'm just telling you, don't send rude nudes. It's digital footprint. You can literally easily have somebody hack and do it. Don't rush to grow up. So I kind of have like a iffy about this, because sometimes you're forced to grow up, so you already have that mental mindset of like you're already up there. But I'm saying, like, if you have had a happy childhood, no problems, don't rush to be grown. I'm just telling you this right now, because 9 times out of 10 you were babied and coddled, so you like don't know what it's like. So I would just chill out on that. That just so. Don't try to plan your entire life. Just, you know, go with the flow. I do kind of agree with this, but I kind of don't, because I kind of have my life planned out. Like, for instance, when I turn 18, which is a year and 9 months. Is it a year and 9 months or a year and 8 months? I don't care, but it's almost here. I plan to leave. Just because I'm tired of being out here. 18 is the best. I feel like 18 is the best. 18 or 19 is the best age to really get out there and see if you like it or not. Because most homes, you can usually just come back if needed. So that's why me and my best friends, we're going to leave. Maybe our significant others. I don't know. But because we don't need no man or no girl. I'm just playing. Yeah, just because we just want to see what's out there. Like, while we're young and while, like, nothing really matters, for real. Friends will come and go. And do not... Okay. Friends will come and go, and do not go looking for friends. When I say don't go looking for friends, I do not go looking for friends. I mean, exactly. And you see why you have none.
Just because I don't
want. Because they're all weird. Do not go looking for friends. Bro, I'm telling you this. I know you may be tired of being lonely or you need more friends. Do not go looking for friends. I promise you, you're going to end up with the wrong people. No, because I need to make sure that they get it. Do not go looking for friends. I'm telling you. Let them come to you. I'm not saying every friend that comes to you is going to be a good friend, but 9 times out of 10, they're going to be better than the friends you go looking for. Do not go do that. Friends will come and go. Do not expect no one to stay. Like, not trying to be mean or anything, but do not expect no one to leave. Expect everybody to leave. If you keep that mindset, 9 times out of 10, you'll not get hurt. Because you already expect it. I mean, don't self-sabotage, but don't be clueless and naive about stuff. Because people can leave any day. Don't be trying to be a cool kid or a cool person. It's just literally an opinion. It doesn't really matter, because I said earlier, it's a mindset. If you think you're cool, I mean, but don't like try to be a try hard or try to do stuff to get people's attention, because people know when you try to do stuff for attention, and then you don't want the name to be a try hard or attention. Yeah, I was gonna say attention H, not H, attention W H O R E. Yeah. Anyways,
my ankle.
Saying no is fine. It's more than fine. It is perfect. It is okay. 100% okay for you to say no. I'm not even a cap to you. I still have problems with saying no because I feel like I'm going to be mean. But as a girl, you need to learn how to say no. Just say straight up no and be okay with that, because nowadays, boys and girls, they don't know what no means. You need to have some oomph in that no. If you need to hit
nope.
If you need to put some manly in that no, it need to be. If you need to put your hands on somebody, need to be. I mean, do it, because no, because like, ooh, because people don't understand what no means. They need a little physical push to it, and that's ridiculous. But as a female, as a woman, a young woman,
I'm sorry.
You're not gonna be any of my videos. You're so cut off. But as a woman, you need to learn how to say no. It's just simple as that. I'm just telling you this right now. As you grow up, saying no is okay. Literally.
May I add into that real quick?
No, I just said you're cut off.
I'm not cut off.
Like I was saying, seek mental help if needed. Do not be scared to get help. I know it's the white people for real. Black people be tripping. I might even a cat to you nowadays. They be tripping OD. But you have better help than getting help from a black person and a white. No, they both suck, actually. I'm not even a cat. Anyways, get help if needed. Do not sit up there fighting your own mind and fighting your mental illness just because you're scared of getting help. Find the help you need. I don't care how long it takes. Find the help you need, because when you get older, it's going to get worse and you will not know how to control it or get better. And you're going to hurt others. Find help, bro. Ooh. Find help, bro. Like, I'm being for real. Trust their gut. I'm not saying much on this. Just trust your gut. If you feel like it's something wrong.
I don't trust my gut.
That's your issue. That's why you're like the way you are right now. Have fun and try new things. Definitely. Do not be like me and be scared and just be basic, because you're not going to get nowhere like this. I mean, I'm kind of getting out of my shell. But have fun. You're 16, 15, 14, 17, 18. Have fun, bro. We're literally on a floating rock. YOLO. Literally, take that seriously. YOLO. Okay, and the last thing that I have. If you're not going to be a content creator or, like, somebody whose work base is on the internet, your social life is not going to matter. It's not. I'm going to just be for real. Like, it's not important. Not to be mean, but it's irrelevant. So, I'm going to say do whatever. Don't do stuff for the internet if you're not trying to be a content creator or influencer. If you're not, do whatever you want. Just like, don't try to be an attention WHORE either on the internet. Just do whatever. She's still cut off. So that ends our video today. Well, my video, because she's still cut off.
I'm not cut off.
She is.
I'm not.
Yeah, it is 8. Can y'all see the time? It is 8:57. This is actually gonna be my shortest video ever. But
how long was it?
It's 14-15 minutes. But yeah, guys, so thank you for watching once again. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you guys help. If you need any more tips or advice, please comment them or text me on any of my socials. Because I do respond. Yes, I do. On my socials, I do. Just make sure you tell me that you're coming for my YouTube video. Or just in general, if you want to talk, here I'm here. If you need help with anything. But that is it. Bye, babies. Mwah. Say bye.
Bye.
You're cut off still.